Hello people, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video we are going to discuss about the layer stackup for mixed signal board design. So in this video we will discuss up to 14 layer of layer stackup from 4 to 14, and here you can see these are like 4 number of options under the 4 layer stackup, and similarly the 4 options under the 6 layer. So we'll kind of discuss like which layer stackup is best as per this criteria. The first criteria is it should have maximum signal layers, so we can route, you know, very dense design on our board. And another selection criteria is proper return path. So return path is basically like when the current initiate from the power or signal track, it in case of signal it finds the shortest return current path for the signal. And for power, it searches for the lower impedance track, right? So we'll discuss that also. The another selection criteria is less EMI due to power tracks or plane. So like as we know that like power tracks and plane contains higher amount of current, right? And because of that current, it radiates the electromagnetic interference, which couples through the lot of signals and can generate noise. So the solution for solution to reduce the EMI is the either we can twist, like if it is external wire, we twist it with ground, so it minimize the EMI radiation. And but in case of PCB, we needed a closest return path for that power track, so the EMI radiation will be like very less. So we'll discuss these things. So like the purpose of this video is like you guys can visualize which layer stackup is best. But before going further, if you guys want to order your PCB assembly from nextpcb.com, just go to the link given in the description and it will direct you to this page. Here you have to log in with your Gmail ID, and after login you have to click over the PCB assembly, and here you have to fill the detail like the number of quantity, number of the assembly pad, number of the through holes pad, now quote now. And here you have to fill all other details like the dimension of your PCB. Now if you guys want to order, just click over the PCB, and here you have to add the quantity. Now click over the calculate, enter the country and the postal service in your country available, add to the cart, and here you have to upload all the three documents like the bill of material and the Gerber file and the pick and place component file. After that, submit. Now the next PCB people will contact you through your mail ID and give you the payment link. So for that, I have find a document. I'm just going through with lot of blocks for the mixed signal stackup, like for higher layer stackup. So I just find this document. So here they mentioned like very, very precise. You can say the design. Criteria, like you should follow this design criteria and your mixed signal design will never fail. So I'll discuss these criteria before going to select like which layer stackup is best, right? So yeah, let's start here. So as you can see, the first criteria is current loop area and ground plane. So here they've given these two examples. The first one is this split plane, as you can see here, right? And they have two sections. So we know that like mixed signal is the board which has digital and analog board kind of signals, right? So as you can see, there is a split plane, that is a split ground plane for the analog and digital, and obviously it's a like closed loop circuitry. So some connections are coming from the analog or coming from digital to analog, and there is a split plane. So because of that split plane, you can see there is no closest return path for these. So it will find a loopy return path around somewhere here or here, right? Which will increase the inductance, and inductance cause the radiation, or you can say the interference between the analog and digital. So this will cause issue and it will damage your analog signal, and because of lot of noise. So what is the best way to route these kind of signals? So as you can see here, they've given this example. So as you can see, there is a ground plane under these tracks. So these tracks are not coming from here and there. These are coming from a focused, or you can say, a section of ground plane which is connected between the digital and analog, right? So here they will find the nearest return path, and there will be like no coupling, or you can say the no interference between the ground and digital, right? So this is the good example of routing, or you can say the bridging analog and digital part, right? Let's see the another thing. So here you can see in one image they have mentioned here. So for this one the return path is like this, but for these sections the return path is directly, right? Stack up, I'm not discussing stack up here because I already discussed there, and after this presentation we'll go back and select the best, you can say the layer stack up for 4 layer, 6 layer, 8 layer, and so on, right? So the next example is power plane overlapping. So when we draw the power plane for analog and digital, right, power planes, it has like ground and positive and negative, obviously ground and signal, or you can say the power planes, the positive signal and negative signal. So here you can see in this image the negative signal of analog, the negative plane of analog is coupling with the, or you can say the overlapping with the digital power plane. So there is a capacitive coupling between these planes, right, which will induce noise on the analog return path, because this is the negative analog which is the return path of positive, right? So you can see there is a capacitive coupling which will cause the issue. So the best way to route the planes for the analog and digital is there will be no coupling between the digital part and analog part. So that is the correct way to route the power plane. Another thing is board partitioning. So we all know that when we purchase a IC chip, suppose an analog to digital or digital to analog converter, so it has both part like digital and analog. So for that we just partition, or we just divide the section of board into digital and analog and route it accordingly, right? So these people just mentioned here, like we should go for the partition in case of mixed signal board. Here we go. So here you can see if we have multiple analog and digital part, right? So they have sectioned it like this. So there is a no, you can say there is no, or you can say there is an isolation between analog to analog part, and obviously it is partitioned properly. So all the digitals are connected, because analog can cause issue with the analog, so it needed partition. But in case of digital, we just needed a little bit clearance between the digital line, and it will not cause any kind of issue, right? Yeah, so that is the good here. They've given this good example. So suppose you have a high frequency signal which is in the analog section. So as you can see here, right? So this is a way of routing. So here you can see the problem is for the clock, the return path is coming like this, right? From here, which is a longer than the, I mean, the better solution, right? And as we already discussed, the longer return path can increase the inductance of the track, which will cause the issue of noise and coupling, right? Similarly, the best way to route the clock or high frequency signal is a little bit ground connect between the analog section. So it is basically under the clock track, which will provide a very precise return current for the clock. So this is a very good example here. Yeah, so this we already discussed. Yeah, another thing is how we should place the decoupling capacitors between the power supply and the ADC. So suppose or I can show you with this layout example. So here we have placed this capacitor. This is the power part, which is the DC-DC regulator, and this is the ADC part, which is here, right? And they have placed capacitor between those, right? So ideally, like this net and this net is kind of same in case of schematic design, right? But when we go for the layout, we should place, so this is the wrong, because like the capacitor is outside the layout, and it will not kind of bypass the noise, bypass the high frequency signal through it, right? Because the power is connected here and ADC is connected here, right? So ideally we should follow the exact schematic design. So according to schematic design, one side is DC-DC regulator, in between there is a capacitors, and other side is analog to digital converter or analog part, whatever it is, right? So we should exact follow this and place the component according to this one, right? So here we go. I will share this document with you guys. You can find the link in the description. Now we can go for the document, and here we're going to discuss which layer stack up is kind of better on the basis of these three or four criteria. So let's start with the four layer stack up, and here we have four options. I'm just going to discuss all these four options, and we'll compare those four options on the basis of these three criteria. And the six layer stack up is for you guys, and just go through with these stack up and just give a thought, like which layer stack up is better on comparison to other option, and just post it on the comment section, and I will have a look later. So the first option is ground, signal and power tracks, signal and power tracks and ground. So okay, so according to like layer stack up, there is a ground, signal and power tracks, there is a core between this signal and power, and then ground plane, right? And we always place component on the top and bottom. Obviously we can't place component inside the layer, so there will be lot of vias. First thing, another thing is apart from vias, it has two signal layers. For four layer stack up, two signal layer is like pretty good. Every signal layer has adjacent ground plane. Every power tracks, or you can say the power local power layers, has adjacent ground plane. That is good, but vias is the biggest issue. Like, so we have to place multiple number of vias to connect the top and bottom component. So I'm just putting this one in the bad category. So I'm just going to write this, and this is kind of bad layer stack up. Now have a look for second option. So in the second option, you can say the ground layers on the internal layers are ground, and outside the power tracks and signal layers. So like whatever the issue we faced on the option one, it is kind of solved here. So this is a good layout, or you can say the good layer stack up. Okay, another is we have signal track, ground, power plane and signal track. So the first signal layer has adjacent ground, so it will be like direct return path. Power plane has adjacent ground, which is the direct return path. Signal layer, so here we have to place vias which will go through the power to ground, but so short of lengthy, but obviously we know that like via dimension is the maximum via dimension is when it's go from top to bottom layer is like maximum 1.6 mm, right? So it's a very small via size. We can directly you can say through via we can directly ground the signal track. So this is also like kind of passing our criteria, these three criteria. So this is also a good layer stack up. Okay, now other one is signal track, ground plane, signal track and power. So see, for power means what? It has high amount of current, right? And it should have adjacent ground, and here the problem is that return path is going through signal. So it can cause issue in case of very dense PCB layout that is in our criteria. Like we are looking for like maximum signal tracks. So I'm putting this one in the bad layer stack up. Here we go. So we have just shorted the two good and two bad layer stack up. Let me know like what you guys think about those layer stack up, and like if I am wrong or if I'm making mistakes somewhere, just correct me in the comment section. And I'm waiting for your guys' reply. Like just go through with this six layer stack up and let me know which one is better. Another is I've gone through with lot of blocks and lot of channels to search for the higher layer stack up, like for 8 layer, which is the good layer stack up for 8 layer, for 10 layer. So this is already shorted, and just gave a thought for these layer stack up also. And if you guys like using higher layer PCB for mixed signal, you can use these kind of layer stack up. So these are like already proven, and yeah. So here we go. Here I'm just going to summarize all everything. So we have discussed what is the design criteria for the mixed signal board, and what is the better, how we think like which layer stack up is better. It should have like maximum, or we can route maximum signal tracks on that layer stack up. It should have proper return path and less EMI on power planes or tracks. Thank you.